Hello students, the topic that we have chosen today is Indian hospitality industry. It means Atithi Devo Bhava, that is, guest is God. Previously, we have talked about global hospitality industry, how this industry throughout the world evolved and what are the various sectors of hospitality industry. In ancient times, travelers were a rarity but could always rely on a meal while passing through. As the centuries progressed, travelers, mostly pilgrims, would be cared for in the temple or monasteries. During the Mughal rule, the forts and surrounds would cater to the need of the travelers, often in exchange of no more than stories of their adventure during their travel or any news from other towns and villages. During the later part of the 18th century and the formation of East India Company by the British, it was apparent that catering requests on a more formal basis were required, and with the advent of the railway in the mid-19th century, small hotels and clubs were becoming part of everyday life of those who could afford to eat out. Prior to the formation of hotels and hotel companies, the club provided any lodging amenities that were required. These clubs were restricted, unfortunately, to Europeans or upper-class Indians. However, it did give many Indians the opportunity to work in a hotel-type environment and become skilled in kitchen and restaurant. These skills were often passed from one person to another. The vast Indian army too required catering on a different scale. An officer's mess then as now resembled high-class restaurant with usually a very good kitchen attached. The princely palaces of many royal Indian Maharajas and families were also run on hotel lines of the present day, at least as far as food and drinks were concerned. Kitchen with Indian and European chefs were considered normal, and the banquet of yesteryears have far outshone anything that is provided today, even of the best 5-star hotel. India and Indians have a long cultured heritage of catering and hospitality. The diversity of the regional dishes and the talent to produce them has long been inherent, and it is because of this fruitful history that India, with its numerous hotel and restaurant, rank among the world's leading hospitality and tourism destinations. When classifying catering establishment, they can be classified on the basis of three main categories, that are residential establishment, non-residential establishment, and non-commercial residential establishment. There is a task for you. Think of various catering establishment and classify them into these three types. There are various catering establishment, for example, into residential, there is hotel, guest houses, holiday parks, farmhouses, public houses, bed and breakfast. Into non-residential, restaurant, cafe, fast food outlet, public houses, wine bar, and then so many other types of outlets. And into non-commercial residential establishment, there is hospitals, residential homes, prisons and armed services. So what is residential? Where you are provided with lodging as well as food. In the non-residential, you are only provided food and beverages. And non-commercial, they run for non-profit basis. Now there is a task for you. Make sure you have included all of these in your brainstorm. So the task which I gave you previously, you must be having some outlet into that. Now you have to give example to each category. For example, there is a fast food outlet, then you have to name one of the outlet that serve fast food, for example McDonald's. Let's talk about some Indian hotel groups. So the first one is Oberoi Hotels. Mohan Singh Oberoi, the chairman and founder of Oberoi Hotel, was born in August 1900 in Bhon, a small village now in Pakistan. Soon after his marriage, in 1922, he arrived penniless in Shimla and found a job as front office clerk in the Cecil Hotel at a salary of Rs. 40 per month. Some years later, moved to Clark's Hotel, also in Shimla, and gained experience in all aspects of hotel operations. In 1934, he bought Clark's Hotel by mortgaging all the asset and selling off his wife's jewelry. In the early 1930s, a cholera epidemic struck Kolkata. Grand Hotel was forced to close. In 1938, Mr. Oberoi acquired the Grand and converted it into a profitable venture. The Oberoi Grand remains to this day Kolkata's one of the leading hotels. The Oberoi Intercontinental in Delhi, which opened in 1965, was the first modern luxury hotel in the capital. 35-storied Oberoi Tower in Mumbai in 1973 was the tallest building in India at that point of time. Oberoi are now the part of international chain of hotels with properties not only in India but also in Australia, Indonesia, Egypt, Iraq, Sri Lanka, Zanzibar, Nepal, Singapore, etc. Mr. Oberoi was named as Man of the World in 1983 at the annual convocation of the International Hotel Association in New York and selected as the Outstanding Hotelier of the Year by the Hotel and Restaurant International. 9 Oberoi hotels are member of the leading small hotel of the world. The Taj Group of Hotels. The Taj Group of Hotels is the largest chain in India with several hotels abroad also. The parent hotel, the Taj Mahal Hotel in the Mumbai, is rated among the 10 best hotels in the world. The founder of the houses of Tatas, Mr. Jamsetji Nusarwanji Tata, in 1897 formed the Indian Hotel Company and built the exclusively beautiful Taj Mahal Hotel in Mumbai. The door opened in 1903 and has been a landmark by the Gateway of India ever since. Now it has more than 70 properties in India. In 1980, the Taj Group took its first step internationally by opening its first hotel outside India, the Taj Sheba Hotel in Sana'a, Yemen, and in the late 1980s acquired interest in Crown Plaza, London, St. James Court, London, and 51 Buckingham Gate Luxury Suite and Apartments in London. The Indian Tourism Development Corporation Limited, that is ITDC, is an hospitality, retail and educational company owned by Government of India under Ministry of Tourism. Established in 1966, it owns over 17 properties under the Ashok Group of Hotels brand across India. ITC Hotel is India's second largest hotel chain with over 100 hotels based out of Hotel Division Headquarters at the ITC Green Center in Gurgaon of New Delhi. Its ITC Hotel is also the exclusive franchisee of the luxury collection brand of Starwood Hotels and Resorts in India. It is part of the ITC Limited. Formerly, it is known as India Tobacco Company. ITC Hotel is regularly voted amongst the best employers in Asia in the hospitality sector. ITC Limited entered the hotel business on October 18, 1975 with the opening of a hotel in Chennai which was Richarist Hotel Chola. ITC Hotels currently own and operate 100 hotels in 75 destinations. ITC Hotel have a reputation of playing host to visiting royalty and world leaders time and again. Its restaurant Bukhara, Peshawari, Dakshin, Dampukt and Kebab and Curries are well-known cuisine brands today. They market a line of food products, kitchens of India. ITC Welcome Group has one of the most extensive art collections in India. A museum of their collection is being planned in Kolkata. In 2004, the Taj Group opened Wellington Mews, its luxury service apartment in Mumbai. In the same year, the Taj Group also launched the first of its value for money hotels in Bangalore, branded Ginger, which division has almost 30 hotels in various locations in India and is owned through its wholly owned subsidiary. Coming up in the next session, we will be discussing about departmental organization, what are various staff members who works in F&B service department of a hotel. Thank you very much.